Experimental and Computational Convection Laboratory at Penn State, which is part of the Turbine Aerodynamics and Heat Transfer Group. We work on fundamental convective heat transfer issues in gas turbine engines.
In a gas turbine engine, air flows first through the fan, next the compressor, next the combustor, through the turbine, and then out the exit. Where we work is in the turbine area, where the environment is extremely hostile due to the high temperature gases that flow over off.
For internal cooling in turbine engine blades, blades are generally hollowed out, as you can see in this image here, to provide cooling in internal channels. The cooling in the internal channels usually is turbulated by some type of features inside of the blade, as you can see here, as well as features that are located within the trailing edge of the blade, such as small pin fin arrays that span the pressure and suction sides of the airflow.
Work that I do is in a large-scale, optically accessible pin fin rig, and I work with particle image velocimetry. Essentially, you have a laser that illuminates particles within a flow field and uses high-speed camera to capture these particles, which you can then translate into a complete three-dimensional vector field.
On the airflow surface, small holes are drilled into the metal, and coolant is pumped through those holes to provide a film of cold air that protects the metal from hot gas path temperatures.
So, my research in the ExCCL lab is on film cooling. So, film cooling holes have a cylindrical metering section with a larger diffuser at the end. And in our rig, we can test multiple complicated geometries of these film cooling holes and vary some parameters of the diffuser in order to get better film cooling effectiveness. Then we can take pictures of the end wall with an IR camera and get pictures like this that show the temperature of the wall, so we can see how effective each film cooling hole is.
One way to measure the velocities in film cooling flows is called laser Doppler velocimetry. It's a system we have in our lab. Basically, you take one or more laser beams and you cross them together at a single point, and at that point you can get the velocity because we seed our flow with very small particles. And whenever a particle goes through this intersection point, because of the interference pattern setup, a series of flashes occurs. And the measurement system can relate how fast the flashes occur to how fast the particle moves. And you can get, depending on all the laser beams you use, you can get all three components of velocity at that point.
In the gas turbine engine, multiple parts such as these are assembled into a full wheel to make the entire turbine. Gaps between individual components are purged with cold air, which can interact with the main gas path flow and create disturbances in that flow path. The complicated flow in the gas turbine engine around the airfoil can result in high metal temperatures.
We have the facilities of a large-scale recirculating wind tunnel. Take scaled engine-relevant hardware, and are able to take test measurements and use diagnostic tools that just wouldn't be possible in an actual engine. In my rig, we use particle image velocimetry to get flow field data in otherwise hard-to-reach areas in an actual engine.
The large-scale wind tunnel allows us to generate the complex flow structures that affect gas turbine heat transfer. My project uses a novel method to consider the combined effects of the external heat transfer and internal cooling. The scaled temperatures that I measure are directly applicable to the engine, so it has been exciting to work on a project so relevant to the gas turbine community.
As a grad student in the ExCCL lab, we study engine-relevant problems using SCHROEDER technologies. For example, we use IR thermography to map the temperature on the end wall surface of the turbine. You're looking at the mixing of the cold purge flows with the hot main gas path. And we use laser diagnostics to measure the velocity fields in those trench regions to explain the mixing that we see. Using state-of-the-art technology to study these industry-relevant problems has helped prepare me for a successful career in the gas turbine field.